Let's check on European markets. They are mostly up in afternoon trade, boosted by corporate updates. Investors in the region also digesting the remarks of the European Central Bank's chief economist, Philip Lane. Lane appeared to back a June rate cut, but cautioned against making predictions about what will happen later. As for Wall Street, futures are mixed ahead of the producer price index and retail sales data, which come ahead of the Federal Reserve's policy meeting next week.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of German renewable energy producer Encavis after an investment firm made a takeover offer for the company. Encavis shares surged 26%. Also in focus, shares of trading platform Robinhood after the company reported a 16% increase in assets under custody in February. Robinhood shares jumped 11% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of troubled e-vehicle startup Fisker after reports surfaced it is preparing for a potential bankruptcy filing. Fisker shares plunged 43% in pre-market trading. And we're also keeping an eye on shares of Anheuser-Busch. Trading of shares of the world's leading brewer was halted in Brussels Thursday after U.S. tobacco giant Altria said it would sell down its stake in the brewer. Its New York-listed stock continues to trade. It dropped 4% in the pre-market.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade mixed ahead of the U.S. data. Japan's Nikkei 225 snapped a three-day losing streak, supported by defensive utility stocks. Australia's ASX 200, meanwhile, closed in negative territory as declines in the financial sector outweighed gains from miners. Here at home, the local market closed flat, with value turnover reaching 7.9 billion pesos.
I think the improving value turnover, even at higher levels, suggests that a lot of investors want to stay in the market. Right now, the market is very strong. We have a very strong uptrend since last year. We've been registering weekly gains for, I think, about past 7 weeks. Okay. And considering today's price action, you know, we think that there's a chance to retest the 7,000 level anew tomorrow.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. now in the Czech Republic for a four-day state visit. Marcos met with Czech Republic President Peter Pavel, with the two leaders confirming a joint communique on the establishment of labor consultation mechanisms for the safe and orderly migration of Filipino workers had been signed. Marcos says he's hoping to further deepen economic cooperation with the European country. This is the two nations commemorate 50 years of bilateral ties.
The global economic landscape now is trying to adapt because the pandemic revealed the weaknesses of supply chain connections, and many countries are looking to expand their economic ties with non-traditional partners. And we're hoping that because of the efforts of both governments, Prime Minister Fiala in April visited the Philippines with a business delegation. President Marcos is visiting this time also with a business delegation. So as far as trade and investment is concerned, we are looking at each other because we have complementary strengths. There are many opportunities for trade and investment to flourish.